This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how job costing can help with assessing the profitability for each job that we work on. And we're going to go back to the custom furniture company that I've been using throughout all of my job costing videos. This is a company that makes wood tables for both individuals and organizations. And what you're looking at here are the three different jobs, and the initial estimate for each job, that's what you see in this column, and the actual results for each job, with our revenue, that's the sales price, product costs, and resulting gross profit. So this is the analysis of each of these three elements, the sales price, the product costs, and the gross profit. Let's focus on job 40 and look at whether our actual results were better or worse than our initial estimate. I should start by going through the estimate information so you see how this works. As a company, we have chosen to establish a sales price based on a markup of 70% of our product costs. This is just an example. It varies from company to company on how they establish their sales price, but for this particular company, let's assume that we are establishing a sales price with a 70% markup, that's what you see here, on our production costs, this $10,800. So 70% of $10,800 is $7,560, that's what you see here, and $7,560 plus $10,800 establishes our sales price of $18,360. Let's assume that the sales price is the contract and that we did indeed get the $18,360 from our customer for this custom table that we built for them. But when you look at the actual column and the costs in the actual column, you see that our total production costs were higher than we anticipated. And we can start to analyze how that happened. That's the advantage of being able to use a job costing system, is we can get into the details and see where those differences took place. And you can see very clearly here that our direct materials is probably the biggest culprit, in that the direct materials were $3,500 and our initial estimate was $1,500, so we were over by $2,000 in that area. Our direct labor was on the high side, as our manufacturing overhead was on the high side by $200. So clearly our production costs of $13,500 were higher than the initially anticipated $10,800 in production costs. As a result, actual gross profit, is significantly lower at $4,860 than our initial estimate of $7,560. Another way to look at this is our gross profit turned out to be about 36% of our production costs rather than our goal of 70%. This is just a starting point of analyzing our actual results with and comparing it to the original estimate. We'd want to dive in further to find out why our direct materials costs were so much higher and why our direct labor costs were a bit higher, as well as the manufacturing overhead costs, and hopefully use this information going forward as we put together estimates for future jobs and bid on future jobs, so that our profitability is where we would like it to be rather than lower than expected, as we see here with job number 40.